Goodbye, Sherry.
Goodbye, Sherry. Bye, Sherry.
You're leaving today. I'm heartbroken, darling.
Will you write to me, Tony?
As long as the post office sells stamps.
No. The post office sells stamps.
It's morning.
Already? You won't forget me, Giuseppe.
Giuseppe?
Never, mi amore.
Giuseppe.
Parting from you is a little like dying, darling.
As soon as I'm gone, you say that to another girl.
Parting from you.
Good morning.
That rooster picked the wrong moment. Couldn't you wait 5 more minutes?
The days are too long, and the nights are too short.
Let's hurry up. We're going to Mr. Trent.
But he's going to.
I mean, blessed silence.
Let's enjoy it.
That big blonde never left me alone.
And the dark-haired one? I had to give her lessons. Guitar lessons.
Miss Dracula. I couldn't get her off my neck.
It's dangerous to teach them to ski. As soon as they can stand up, they tear after you.
Gentlemen, gentlemen.
Mr. Max, I need some sleep.
I've been up since 6. You had a whole night to rest.
Not according to our contract.
It only states that you have to entertain the guests. That's what it says. No more. The interpretation is yours.
Already?
Reception committee, gentlemen. It's in your contract.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Mr. and Mrs. Washburn, room 18.
Karen Sloan.
Miss Sloan, please.
Thank you. Susan Halsey.
Miss Halsey, room 5.
To teach me.
I'm going... No, I don't think so. You're in the beginner's class.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Here you are.
Miss Sloan?
Karen, I came a long, long way to meet you, so I have to be in your class. Tony.
Karen.
I'm going to be your best man.
Karen.
I'm Brian Davis, the new instructor.
Please wait over there, Mr. Davis, until I've taken care of the guests.
Mr. Davis, I'm Tony Brunt. This is Franz, Karl,
Hello.
Hans, Giuseppe. You take over the beginner's class.
Too bad. I don't mind.
He doesn't mind.
Room 6 for Miss Karen Sloan. The key to room 6.
Here.
Mesdames et messieurs, faites votre jeu. It's your turn, Franz.
It won't be easy. She has a crash on you.
I say 16.
16.
I believe in Franz's invincible charm.
10. 10.
What are you talking about?
I bet 40.
As you've heard, gentlemen, I've put Miss Sloan in room 6. Did you make your bets?
Here's a list.
I put myself down for 3.
Oh.
I have complete confidence in Mr. Franz.
I'm touched. I won't let you down, Mr. Max.
What's this all about?
For members only.
All right, make me a member.
We shall have to put your request for membership before the committee at its next meeting.
Right.
You should be in my class. I teach the beginners.
Oh, no, I'm in Tony's class. But can you give me a quick lesson?
Here?
Yes. If I'm not good enough, he'll kick me out. How is my balance? Can you improve it?
Well, you could bend your legs a little.
Supposed to be my turn.
Who?
Sorry.
Why don't you use the ski bob? Then you'll never know.
Oh, yes, this is a good idea.
But we're all here.
Mexican. Here I am.
The machine must have a short.
Davis isn't here.
The American?
There's a nice view from room six.
Room six?
Congratulations, track record, fastest time ever. Very good.
What are you talking about?
Shall I pay off?
Wait.
I came close this. I get a putt.
But Brian doesn't belong to the club. The whole thing doesn't count.
Well, he messed up the game. Yeah. Let's start from scratch. I'll move somebody else into room six.
That pretty girl from California.
Oh, that French one. I'm still next.
I thought that machine was out of order.
It certainly cannot be played by coins.
Welcome home.
Mr. Davis, you are much too hospitable.
Here's a safe place for you, Miss Halsey.
I'm sorry.
We must choose the fox.
Yes.
Quiet! Quiet for a moment! Who is going to be the fox?
Tony should be the fox.
That wouldn't be fair. Tony's too smart for you beginners. You would never catch him.
How about you, Carl?
No, he's too good. How about Mr. Davis? An American fox. Yeah! Yes! Let's see how good he is.
I'll let you find out.
The fox will wear this cap. He loses if one of us gets close enough to pull it off.
I'm going to put it on. And I'm going to take it off.
You'll have to sit on my lap to get it off.
You have a head start. Let me be on your tail. I'm clocking you out right now. Get moving.
I'll see you at the hotel tonight. All of you.
Hey, Brian. Wait. Here's the trail confetti. And you change direction, throw out a handful.
Quiet, please. Let's make a countdown. 10.
again.
Yes, let's go back.
All right, girls, let's turn.
Everybody
careful,
back.
Watch out.
Those
careful,
guys.
Careful.
Hurry up.
Himself. Thank you.
bus where you're going.
And up here and down the other side. Leave the skis here. Come on, quick!
Have their fun chasing me. They need the ski lessons. Here, have a drink.
What is it?
It's my favorite wine, a substitute for a Saint Bernard.
I told you I'd catch you.
How do you know the fox didn't catch you?
Don't give me that. It was my skill and my speed and my everything.
That's right. You're everything. Well, it's nice to meet you here in the hay.
Well, it was pretty sneaky of you to leave the snow and get in the hay.
All foxes are sneaky. Haven't you ever met one before?
It's getting warm.
It's the wine.
Hello! Hello! I caught the fox!
The word is not hello. It's tally-ho.
Tally-ho!
And all in here, and all over. Both of them are very fast foxes.
Oh, Brian. You are a dishonest fox.
Dishonest?
Let yourself get caught by a girl.
Oh, I think he's a foxy fox. With all the hay on his back and on hers.
You got the wrong idea.
I took the liberty of moving Miss Karen Sloan to another room.
Good.
Miss Dominique Lucerne now occupies room 6.
I think it's Tony's turn.
Oh, a pleasure. To Dominique, what's her name?
Lucerne.
Lucerne. Mesdames et messieurs, faites votre jeu.
I bet 5.
No, 16. She's too smart a girl.
20 for me.
I say 10.
Put myself down for 3 hours. For late this afternoon. Let me pinpoint it. During, after ski.
Oh, I'm flattered by your trust in me, Mr. Max.
Psychology. I'm never wrong. That's my desk bell. Excuse me.
Now that I'm a member of the club, don't you think you ought to let me in on some of the ground rules?
Why not?
The girl in room 6 is, how do you say, the target for tonight. One of our group makes her acquaintance, her personal acquaintance. And how long it takes. The moment of truth is registered on this pinball machine.
Yeah. When you got into that room with that Sloan girl, it registered right here.
It seems like kind of a mean trick.
Why? It's like a ship's pool. The one who comes closest in guessing the actual mileage takes all.
I guess I just don't see the fun of it.
What do you think they come here for, to ski? They come here to join the open season and ski instructors, and you are one of us.
We got it in our contract that we have to mix with the guests after skiing.
Not in mine.
No? Look up the small print in your contract. The game is our way of getting even.
Now you know. How much do you want to bet, Brian? Just guess how many hours.
No thanks. Deal me out.
He'll change his mind as soon as he gets burned.
Will you kindly explain to me why this creature is removing my luggage? Put it back.
We have a much lovelier room for you. Overlooking...
Oh, I don't care if it overlooks the moon. I want my room back. This one, put it back. Where's Tony?
He's down at the bar. I'm sorry, this is all beyond my control. You see, the room had already been reserved a year in advance.
I'll reserve it.
I wish I could. I tried very hard. As you can see, my hands are tight. I did everything I could, but we have all to make way for the ambassador.
What ambassador?
From the United Nations. Very important.
The ambassador?
French ambassador.
Crazy French.
Moonlight on the snow, what a sight to see. Everywhere you go, it's a winter scene for me. Fir trees bending down, make a snow-capped sea. Music all around, it's a winter scene for me. Sleigh bells ring a familiar tune as we sing along. January is planning on June. It's a happy song. Moonlight on the snow, while you're here with me. Everywhere we go, it's a winter symphony. Everywhere you go, it's a winter symphony. Music all around, it's a winter symphony. Sleigh bells ring a familiar tune as we sing along. January's planning on June. It's a happy song. Moonlight on the snow, while you're here with me. Everywhere we go, it's a winter symphony. It's a winter symphony. It's a winter symphony.
Like to dance?
Okay. I don't care where I get my claustrophobia.
Hey little girl, come on and dance for me. Hey little girl, come take a chance for me. Don't just stand there out on the floor. Hey little girl, I've noticed you before. Come on and dance.
Dance,
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 dance.
Hey little girl. Hey little girl, it's time you gave a try. Hey little girl, don't let it pass you by. Let the music play and be free. Hey little girl, come on and dance for me. Come on and dance.
Dance,
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 dance. Hey little girl.
Over me again?
You promised to dance with me.
Did I? Only on ski.
Hey, little girl. Hey, little girl.
Quiet, please. The time has come to honor the brave hunter who caught the wily fox. The victorious hunter. Miss Susan Halsey. From Azusa in California.
She's the queen of the evening. And here's her crown. A crown of genuine fox fur. Now a few words from the queen.
Well, there are foxes and there are foxes. Those with fur and those without. My crown comes from one with fur. However, you have to look out for the ones without it. They're very smart. They'll out-ski you, they'll out-talk you, and they're extremely dangerous until they're caught.
Hooray! Party foxes! Party foxes! Party foxes!
Little girl, come on and dance for me. Hey, little girl, come take a chance for me.
You shouldn't have warned them.
Don't They're so innocent and shy, the poor dears.
Well, you shouldn't make them suspicious. You should leave them unspoiled.
Dance, 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 dance. Hey, little girl.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Hey, little girl, it's time you
came. I'm out of bank, Ron.
Love it.
In room six?
I got no Nikolai.
I'll furnish it.
No.
Let the music play and be free. Hey, little girl, come on and dance for me. Come on and dance, 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 dance. Hey, little girl.
What does a fox do except teach skiing and abduct girls from dances?
He studies music in Vienna and picks up a job during the holidays.
Nothing. It's a nice job teaching predatory girls how to ski, picking them out of the snow.
I'm assigned to the teenagers and the toddlers.
I'm on a ski flight from California. You know, the reduced fare, reduced hotel, reduced everything. I came here to ski.
Mm-hmm.
Don't spoil this lovely night by playing that old game.
I didn't know that game could ever get old.
Men shouldn't take girls for granted simply because they met them on skis.
What about the girls chasing the ski teachers? You know, the local priest begged the girls from the pulpit to leave the instructors alone? Well, I have it in my contract. I have to entertain the guests after skiing.
Well, you needn't entertain me according to your contract, Mr. Davis.
Oh, come on, Susan. You know I didn't mean you. Let's not go back in there. It's so noisy. Besides, the mood's better out here.
Made it.
2 hours and 46 minutes. I guess it almost to the second.
You're a man of experience. Here's the money.
Thank you.
Clerk. Huh? My name is Armand Gauthier. I want my room.
Sorry, we are booked up.
But I have a reservation for a suite.
Suite?
Suite. I've paid for it in advance.
Oh, but we expected you with the morning train.
I came by car. My rooms were reserved for this week, if I was here or not. Rooms adjoining Mademoiselle Lezer's, Dominique Lezer's.
Of course, of course.
Of course.
Please register, Mr. Gauthier. Oh, how clumsy of me. Psst, psst.
Clerk, give me another pen. It doesn't write.
Sorry. Take this one, sir. Yeah. Move 6 to 15, and pronto. Knock and say, arrival from Paris. Quickly.
Clerk, where is Mademoiselle Lezer?
In the apres-ski room, I'm sure. Waiting for you, sir.
I have her paged.
This is difficult. But if you would like to have a look yourself, I'm sure you'll find her.
Myself?
Yes.
Bon. Where is the apres-ski room?
Downstairs in the second floor.
Downstairs?
Yeah.
Oh.
I could not find her.
You couldn't find her?
No.
Shall I call her room?
No, no. I'd like to surprise her.
I understand.
What is my room?
Room 15.
The key.
Room 15. Heidi? Room 15 for Mr. Gauthier.
No, no.
The key to room 6.
The glow shave. Glow shave.
What are you crying about? Haven't you got the money? As soon as possible. I took my fastest car. But you look pale, Cherie. Pale. You need some sun.
You know, I don't ski. I'm so bored. All I did was read magazines. And to think of you, Tony.
Tony?
Tony?
Who is Tony?
Tony, that's what they say here. Oh. It is an expression like darling or Schatzi or sweetheart.
I understand. Kiss me. Tony.
Yes. Tony.
Good morning. You're up early. Juice and coffee.
I told you I came here to ski.
I wish you were in my class.
I haven't graduated yet. No one ever does.
Miss Halsey? Good morning. I have a surprise for you.
What is it?
If I tell you, it wouldn't be a surprise.
But I'm not very fond of surprises.
You like this one. Bring your skis along.
My skis?
Yeah, that's the general idea.
I'll see you at 4 right here. Same room, same chair.
Promise you too much?
It's so beautiful. Thank you for the invitation.
Come on. I'll take you through my private world, which I usually don't share with anybody. Come.
got the key to this place?
Of course, I own it. Do you like it?
It's lovely.
It's even nicer inside. Come in. The pilot knows where to find us. Come. How do you like my pad?
Your pad?
Yes.
You've had other American girls up here besides me.
How'd you know?
How else would you know the expression?
I taught many of them to ski and picked up their vocabulary. Pad, cool, camp. Just try me.
Looks like a wolf's den to me.
No wolves in this part of the country. They have died out.
I wonder. You know how to make a girl smile?
Like that?
Peter, I am so hungry and thirsty.
That can be helped.
It's getting dark outside by now. I wonder if the helicopter can still land.
Oh, he's a night pilot.
I see. Champagne wolf's den.
Yes.
The trap is being baited.
With lots of goodies. Still afraid?
Of wolf serving champagne? Of course.
Thank you. Cheers.
We have this chair.
I'm sorry, I'm expecting someone. Captain?
Yes?
Where are Tony and Susan?
At Stone Mountain.
When are you going to pick them up?
Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Don't worry. Tony has a chalet, all heated up. And the girl, too.
Giocare con l'amore. sir. I couldn't help overhearing your conversation with that pilot.
So?
You're an instructor, aren't you? I've watched you since you arrived. You're different from the others.
Look, what do you want?
McDougal, private detective from Edinburgh, Scotland. I'm representing 11 young maidens, school teachers. They went skiing and returned back home, 11 of them, in a changed condition. I'm looking for certain gentlemen to bring charges against them.
Why ask me?
I'm investigating. We have to protect the innocent.
Yeah, well, when you find out who the innocent are, you tell me, huh?
That young lady up in the mountains, taking her up in the helicopter. That also happened to three of my clients.
Well, it's pretty late to do anything about that.
I have a plan. But we'll have to act fast. Why don't you follow me? Come on. See that bell? People here use it in case of emergency. Just follow me. The Alpine distress signal.
Where?
Up there.
Stone Mountain?
Tony's up there. He's in trouble. Come on.
You coming?
I can't ski.
More champagne.
Oh.
You better get another one.
All right.
Listen to the storm.
Hmm. Storms come up here quite suddenly. Knew it would happen.
A short?
Yeah, I think the storm blew down a line.
You promised me more champagne.
Oh, you'll get drunk.
Well, if I get drunk now, then I'll have a good excuse afterwards.
That makes sense.
What's that?
Hey, there's a light on up there in the hut. Let's check it out.
You think it could be Tony up there?
I don't know, and I don't care.
there.
Hey, Tony! I'm out there!
Tony!
Answer!
What's the idea?
Didn't you send up flares?
Flares? Didn't you want to be rescued?
Who wants to be rescued?
The Brian saw flares and rang the bell.
What kind of gag is that?
What kind of gag is a storm that comes out of a loud speaker?
Oh, switch it off, Carl.
Oh, Champlain, let's have a party.
Don't you think I'm old enough to take care of myself?
I should have known. If Tony gets into trouble, he doesn't want to be rescued. Here, Brian.
Not my champagne.
I've got my own sauce.
Three letters for you, Miss Le Sœur.
From Armand, Armand, Armand. No variation ever.
Who is in room 6?
I kept it free, waiting for the decision of the club.
Put Miss Halsey in it.
Heidi? Move Miss Halsey from 5 to 6.
Why don't you pick on somebody else? You won't have a chance to send up a rescue party this time.
Isn't it my turn?
This time I volunteer.
Tony! I think your game stinks.
It's against the rules of the club to be jealous, Mr. Davis.
I'm not jealous. You'll never make it with her. You haven't got a chance.
You want to bet?
Sure.
Ryan wants to bet on room 6 and Susan.
I'll bet you wind up with egg on your face.
I don't know that expression, but it sounds pretty nasty. How about betting? $20?
How about 50?
How about 100?
How about 500?
That's almost your salary for the season. I accept.
You got it.
One condition. Don't tell her about room 6.
I won't have to.
Messieurs, dames, faites votre jeu.
Oh, leave me alone.
I'm sorry about the mix-up, Miss Halsey. Room 5 was promised weeks ago. It's my fault. I can't blame anyone else. Please forgive me. I'm sure you'll be very happy in here.
Now they got you in room number 6. Yeah. First they had you, then they had Dominique, and now they have me. It's like musical chairs. Why? I smell a rat.
A rat?
My previous room looked exactly like this. It had the same view, had the same furnishings, it had the same everything. And yet every day Max moves someone else in here. Why?
Search me. Maybe he enjoys moving people around. What are you doing?
I have a strange feeling. Maybe this room is bugged.
What?
Or these are trick mirrors.
Trick mirrors? I better get out of here.
Thank you. Yes? Yes, Miss Halsey. Huh? A bottle of champagne and 2 glasses. I'll have it sent to your room pronto. I don't understand. You want me to bring it up? I cannot leave the desk. Of course, if you insist. Take over, I'll be back soon.
champagne on the table?
Yes.
No, open it.
I'm sorry.
I want to talk to you.
To me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not supposed to drink when I'm on duty.
Well, you'd make an exception for me, wouldn't you, Max?
Yes.
To you. I've been thinking about you.
About me?
Mm-hmm. Always working. Always taking care of other people. Everyone else has fun except for poor Max. It isn't right.
It's my job.
Yeah, but all work and no play. That's not healthy for a man in his best years. Like you.
Thank you, Miss Halsey.
Call me Susan.
Of course, Miss Halsey.
Let me tell you a secret. I've never liked men under 40. But a man like you, substantial, experienced, isn't selfish, and above all, a girl can feel secure.
I know what you mean.
Max, sit here beside me.
No, I shouldn't.
Don't you like me?
Of course I do, but you see...
Well, I thought that's why you moved me to room 6. First it was Karen Sloan and then Dominique, and now you picked me.
It's a coincidence.
What's the secret of this room?
No secret, none at all.
Is there a peephole in the wall or a hidden microphone?
Of course not.
Then what is it? I know there's a secret. Why don't you tell me?
Miss Halsey. I mean Susan.
That's better.
I'll give you another room, right away.
First, tell me why.
Room 5, the one you had before. Yes, I'll move you back to room 5.
But what's the matter with this room?
It's because of the game.
The game?
Yes, we have a pool. We bet how much time it takes for one of the instructors to be invited to room 6, that's all.
I don't understand. What's wrong with that?
Susan, you see, here under the bed, there is a contact attached to the springs with an electric wire. It runs to the wall. The wire leads to the window. Then down the outside wall to the pinball machine downstairs in the bar.
How quaint.
When the electric contact closes under the bed, the pinball machine starts flashing. It doesn't connect with the weight of one person, but with two. That's the secret.
I understand. Who thought all this up?
We've been playing the game for years. But you see, if the pinball machine were to flash now, that would be embarrassing to me. Somebody might have seen me enter the room 6. Let me shift you to 5 for your protection.
And you moved me into this room as a kind of partner in this game?
No, no. I'd never have dared. Tony asked me to do it.
Tony?
Yes, Miss Halsey.
Get out of here!
Yes, Miss Olsen.
And if you breathe one word that I know, I'll have you fired.
Yes, of course, Miss Olsen. I wouldn't tell anyone. I'd lose my job.
Now get out.
Making a good martini is to get the glasses ice cold and you mix it 10-1 with just a pinch of salt.
Salt?
That's the secret. Hi.
Hi.
Hi. May I tell you a secret?
Yeah, what is it?
I can't go into the water. I suffer from hydrophobia.
From rabies? I mean from aquaphobia.
Yes, that's what I suffer from.
Uh-huh. And why this outfit?
Still sore?
Of course not. I like all men and women. Well, what else can I wear? This is a pool, isn't it? Oh, Tony!
Can you swim as well as you can ski?
Why don't you find out?
Hmm.
Give me another, make it a double.
Same for me.
And one for your slave.
Slave? I hear it's giving you freedom. Mm. How about another bet?
He doesn't have a chance. I know American girls.
Maybe in America. But over here, they get rid of their inhibitions like old clothes. And they put them back on when they go home.
I'm glad you keep your eye on all the girls.
Every girl needs to be looked after.
Try me, and I don't.
Tony! 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 I'm here!
Water? But not very long. The bathing suit is dry. Tell me, Susan, what makes you so sure?
It's easy to find out.
But how?
Just ask me. I'm in room number 6.
Sir, here's your salted martini.
I got the green light.
Watch the pinball machine.
Doesn't mean a thing.
I make it easy for you. I let you off the hook.
I never welch on a bet.
All right. I spent your money and champagne and room service.
No, sir. Yuppie, I did not. Sorry. Hello, Fountain.
Hi.
Man, why'd you go drink?
Me? Oh, thank you. I'll take a rain check on it. I got myself a date.
The pinball machine hasn't lit up yet.
It will. Just stick around.
It's 8.
Let's go, girls.
Maybe we're tired.
8?
We must
come on upstairs.
Come on, Judy.
What's got into them?
Hey.
Come on, let's play.
Who's the winner?
Stupid question.
Gentlemen, good night.
Want to do anything about that outrage?
They're two grown-up people.
I never had such a miserable time in all my life.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi. Don't lock the door.
But you don't want anybody to come in. What's the matter?
Well, this is the first time I've ever had a man to my room.
Oh, you have been to my chalet and didn't play coy? Why'd you look at me like that?
I just wondered what makes you so irresistible to women.
You know what it is?
No.
I like them. And because I like them so much, the honesty of my emotions transfers itself to them. That's psychology.
You're a deep thinker, Tony.
No, not really. I just like to figure things out. Oh. Too much light? May I?
It's hot in here.
Who screamed?
I don't know. It must have been a cat.
A cat? Where are you going? Susan, do you have a hanger for my trousers? Thank you. Susan, make it snappy. Otherwise, I'll come and get you.
Double-crossing jerk.
What do you mean by that?
Double-crossing jerk. You told her about the room and the bet.
I didn't tell her a thing.
Don't give me that. Tipping her off was the only way to win your bet. Gustav, give Davis his $500.
You must really think you're the top of the heap, Brand. Otherwise, you wouldn't mind losing so much.
You could never win an honest competition.
All right, if you think I cheated you, I'll give you a chance to win your money back.
On what?
Tomorrow, in the giant slalom.
Brian, don't be foolish. You haven't got the chance.
Don't stop him. If he insists on breaking his neck, I'm in favor.
Okay.
Gentlemen, closing time.
Have gathered to compete today at the annual highlight of the season, the International Austrian Ski Instructors Championship here in San Paulus. We are a very few minutes away from the first start of the race. Number one is Franz Hofer from Austria. Today's giant slalom for the famous trophy of San Paulus promises fast times, since last night's low temperatures made the slopes icy and extremely difficult. Since the early morning hours, a crowd of thousands has lined up along the steep course, which was set by Austria's former national champion, Roland Schaefer.
Susan! Susan!
Excuse me, please.
That I don't ever want to talk to him again.
She doesn't ever want to talk to you again.
Why?
I am not a horse. I don't like to be bet on, for winning or for losing. I'm insulted.
She's not a horse. She doesn't want to be bet on, not for winning or for losing. She's insulted.
Please tell her I'm sorry.
He's sorry.
I will never forgive him. Tell him that.
She will never forgive you!
Tell her I love her.
He loves you!
Ha!
Racers start at 1 minute intervals. A racer not at the start when his number is called will be automatically disqualified.
Listen, Tony. I want to tell you that you are mean and awful to provoke Brian to run against you.
I didn't provoke him. I'd love to win that bet, that's all.
Tony, please let him win.
Let him win? Are you crazy? He needs a lesson.
But he's going to break his neck and you'll be blamed for it.
I have no time to argue, baby. Leave me alone. Oh, what a lousy thing to do.
I'm out of the race!
Number one to the starting gate.
Number one.
Number and two in now. The slot.
Five,
number
four,
three, ready.
Two, one, go.
Number two, Pierre Gérard from Chamonix.
Franz Hofer, Austria's three-time Olympic gold medal winner, is on the slope. Number three to the starting gate. Number four in the slot. Number five, ready.
What are you doing?
Take mine. I'm number 10. I've got more time to look for another thong.
But why are you doing this?
Well, let's just say I don't want to win by default. Thank you, Brian.
Number four to the starting gate. Number Franz Hofer has drawn the most sought-after starting number one and is now using this advantageous position to go all out and add the first prize of St. Paulus to his collection of Olympic gold medals. While waiting for Franz Hofer, I might add that, for the third time, Tony Brandt from Austria is trying to defend his title. And for the first time, we have a racer from the United States of America, Brian Davis. And now comes Franz Hofer, shooting down the last slope, throwing his body far forward as if trying to jump all the way to the finish line. A great style, an excellent time.
Time so far, 2 minutes, 40.5 seconds by Franz Hofer, Austria.
And here comes Tony Brandt, skiing as if shot from a cannon, dancing between the flags like a cat, looking for the shortest way through the gates, fighting for split parts of a second. We just received word of his halfway time, a fantastic 1 minute, 18.3 seconds. He is in great form. With tremendous courage, he throws his body as close to the flagpoles as possible. Tony Brandt, around at the 15th or 16th gate, now going all out to recapture his crown for the third straight time. Here he comes. I think he did it. A new record. Fans almost throwing to the ground.
Number 8 to the starting gate. Number 9 in the slot. Number 10, ready.
Thank you. That was a nice way out.
Out of what?
The race.
I'm not out of the race.
But you can't without your own thong.
These bindings will hold.
No, they won't. She's right, Brian.
You really think I gave Tony my thong so I could chicken out of the race?
No, I guess you didn't. You did it because I asked you to.
I did it because it's something I want to do.
Number 9 to the starting
gate. Hurry up, Brian. Your number's
number
been called.
Number 10 in the slot. Number 11, ready.
Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
It's now number 10 for his way. Number 11, Peter Jump.
Here comes the American, Brian Davis. His speed through the first gates is tremendous.
After all your tops.
Without Brian's help, I wouldn't be here.
Davis seems determined to win this race. The line he chooses through the gates is very risky and extremely fast.
I'm glad he found another thong.
So am I.
Skiing French style with elbows far out, he throws himself through the gates. I just learned that his halfway time equals that of Tony Brandt. The course by now has become tough to ski. The first 9 racers have worn dangerous moguls into the track. Davis takes them a little too fast. He's getting into trouble. He's losing his ski. He fell. He comes out of the slope. I don't know what's happened to him. He's out of the slope. He's out of the race. It seems his binding didn't hold and opened when he edged his right ski after the 40th gate. We hope that he isn't seriously hurt. We'll know in a minute what the situation is.
I knew this would happen.
The first aid team has already reached him.
Winner of today's giant slalom with 2 minutes, 40.1 seconds, Tony Brandt.
You would have won the race.
Don't bet. Ever.
matter how I try. Men and boys treat girls like toys and laugh to see them cry. Man or boy, boy or man, they never seem to grow up. Sooner or later they show up, doing all they can to hurt a girl. Boy or man, man or boy, they find it so amusing. Sooner or later they're losing all they can employ to hurt the girl. Don't they know the games they play are wrong right from the start?
Expect somebody else. You are a dangerous girl.
Dangerous?
May I tell you a secret? I always was afraid to fall in love with you.
Parting is a little like dying.
That's what I always say.
I'm heartbroken, darling.
Will you write to me, Mr. McDoodle?
As long as the post office sells stamps.
But that's my line. Oh, that was my line.
Oh.